Second floor, Ministry of Education, Jogo House, was the scene of a confrontation between the police and members of the civil society who'd kept a whole night vigil. Chanting songs calling for Professor Sam Ongeri's resignation from the Education Ministry, the civil society activists dug in and refused to yield, even as the police threatened to forcefully remove them. They made good their threat by finally chaining the door leading to the minister's office. At that point, the police decided they had had enough from the protesters and quickly swung into action. Whisking them away into a police car that took them to the central police station. The drama unfolded a day after Professor Sam Ongeri put a strong defense, claiming that Treasury had all along kept him in the dark over the missing funds by withholding a report on the scam. The group was later released and went back to camp outside Jogo House, vowing to stay there until Ongeri resigns over the 4.6 billion shilling scandal.
Tumeamua tutashinda hapa, tutashinda tukirudi, tukienda, tukirudi. Mpaka Ongeri atakapong'atuka.
Chair of the Parliamentary Committee on Education, David Koech, has called for investigations into the issue to be expedited.
We should never ever condone corruption as a sector. And I want to state here that the agencies that we have put in place as a nation, the leadership in this country, must ensure that they act and they perform.
Ang'atuke ama tumung'oe.
Ang'atuke ama tumung'oe.
Pressure continues to mount on the education minister to take political responsibility for the scandal. The United Kingdom has demanded a refund of up to 7 billion shillings issued in grants to the FPE program. Bonnie Odinga, KTN Prime.